Okay, I said I was gonna try and do this in one shot, but I feel like it's gonna be more than that. I am so nervous. I'm gonna try it. Okay, so bear with me. So I'm going to do the first bit as just who am I and how I got into fitness, and then I'm going to go into a little workout video here in Mallorca. I didn't even say that bit. I am in Mallorca at the moment. I have the best grandpa in the world, so shout out, and he has a house here, so we nipped on over and we're just, you know, having a little bit of chill time before, fingers crossed, the gyms open again. I am Celia Sheridan. I am 26 years old. I'm from Manchester. I live in Sheffield because I went to uni there. So I have a degree in business and marketing. I'm very open with everything that I've been through. I've struggled with depression and mental health my whole life. Slightly autistic, so that's been an issue for a very long time. And a bit of a weird family life. So yeah, the main things that I kind of focus on in my life, or focus on dealing with through fitness, is PTSD, which I have suffered with for a number of years now, depression, anxiety, low confidence. Yeah, pretty much, I guess, a wide range of mental health problems. But yeah, so that leads me perfectly into how I got into fitness. I went to counselling for a very, very long time, in and out, as I think everybody does when they're doing counselling. So yeah, after my first or second, I can't remember what it was, stint in trying to do counselling, my counsellor suggested that I try going to the gym. And I think I was just entering my fourth year of uni, actually, because I had made a very, very good friend that's still one of my best friends to this day, Grace, and she was like, yeah, let's go to the gym together. At this point, I was 44% body fat. I was technically obese, and I had no clue that I was unhealthy at all. I ate my feelings a lot. Yeah, but I decided to go. We got a PT together straight away, which was probably the best thing for me, because it really, I'm better at doing things for other people. So if my PT asked me to do something, I did it. And there wasn't a question in my mind whether I was gonna do it. I just did it. I like making other people happy. So basically, I fell in love with fitness, and then I learned that I was overweight and probably could have been doing it a lot sooner. So it turned into my therapy, and I kind of switched counseling out for a little bit. I used to sit on a bike for half an hour every single day at 5 o'clock in the morning before I went to work. And most days I would just sit there and cry. So if you ever saw me doing that, you can probably remember the tears coming down my face. I didn't really care for how I looked at the time. Like, I knew I didn't look as good as I could look, or as good as I looked when I was younger. But I didn't really care. Like, it would never crossed my mind. I don't know why. I guess I was very big into like the whole makeup scene at that point. So I had contour to save my life instead. Didn't think about the bottom half of me. I mean, I did like do that whole like weight creeping up on you thing. You were aware of it, but you can't really be asked to do anything yet. So I went on a high fat, high protein diet, which I wouldn't be able to do now, I don't think. But it definitely helped my brain. And although being a calorie deficit is the main thing, I'll always love that period of my life, because it really helped my depression more than I would ever have thought it had. Or would. And yeah, fell in love with weightlifting. I went from, in the January to around the May, June, I went from 44% body fat, 77 odd kilos, to 20% body fat, 62 kilos, I want to say. With a very strict diet, but I guess I found it easier to do because of the depression. So it was easier to have like a routine for me. And it helped make the rest of my life a lot better. And then we're gonna flash forward to today. I am a PT. I've been a qualified PT for 3 years now. I have a really great client base. They're more like a family now. And they're all about balance, mental health, all that side of it. It's less about how you look for me and more about how you feel. And yeah, that's something I put into like all kind of walks of my life, I think. So we're gonna do a workout, and then at the end we're gonna do a little bit of this or that, and then what's to come from this YouTube channel. I really hope you enjoy it. I hope I get a little bit more calm and you get to know me. So yeah, wish me luck. Always wanted to do that. In the corner of my best friend's sofa, you were getting by some rum and cola. Wasn't brave enough yet just to talk to you. Not a smooth talker, under pressure. Sweaty palms ain't making it much better. Something about you feels so special. Pretty ugly from the minute that I met you. Get your attention. You make me nervous. In the corner of my best friend's sofa, you were getting by some rum and cola. Wasn't brave enough yet just to talk to you. Not a smooth talker, under pressure. Sweaty palms ain't making it much better. Something about you feels so special. Pretty ugly from the minute that I met ya.
Take a seat, Celia. Welcome to This or That.
Shout out to it being Katie's idea.
Who's Katie?
Are you joking?
Who's Katie?
My best friend.
You need to tell the camera who Katie is.
Best friend, ride or die. Love her forever. She's great. But don't check her out on Instagram because she's a fucking hermit.
Right. So we have This or That. We have a few responses from Celia's Instagram. So, do you want to explain the rules of This or That? What it is? How do you do it?
I just choose This or That. For example, sweet or savoury.
Is it like
I'm meant to do it quickly?
Is it like a quick response.
Savory. Yeah, it's got to be quick. For those of you who don't know me, I'm not very decisive, so your chance to get to know me.
All right, we're gonna start with mine. Coffee or sleep?
Coffee.
Ooh, interesting. Joggers
always
or
nice coffee.
Joggers or jeans?
Joggers.
Obviously. Lashes or eyebrows?
Eyebrows.
Gin or juice?
Juice. Yeah.
Arnie or Frank?
Arnie.
Oh, Amy or Liv?
I'm not answering that.
Terry chocolate orange or nachos?
Nachos.
Warm weather or cold weather? Is that hard? Why is that hard?
I love skiing. And I like snow. Warm weather.
Wee or poo?
Poo. Everybody loves good poo, right?
Sun or rain?
Sun.
Pizza or Chinese?
Pizza.
Beach holiday or city break?
Oh, a bit of both.
No.
That's why it's perfect here.
No. Beach holiday.
City.
Clothes or pyjamas?
Pyjamas.
Ice cream or chocolate?
Chocolate.
Singing or dancing?
Dancing. She when I'm drunk. I can't do either.
Cake or donuts?
Donuts.
Five Guys or McDonald's?
Five Guys.
No,
it makes me salivate.
I hate Five Guys. It is great.
So it's like get to know Frank, just get to know Seaman.
Oh, sorry. Shower or bath?
Me either. Shower.
She doesn't actually want.
I don't do that.
Mini golf or bowling?
Bowling. Catch me at my birthday every year, bowling. This is definitely sideways.
Yeah, it's slanting more.
It's slanted. Does anyone mind? Do you mind?
You can flip it. Sainsbury's or Tesco?
Tesco, because Sainsbury's don't let my dog inside.
Ketchup or mustard?
Ketchup.
Food or drink? 3, 2, 1.
Food.
0161 or 0114?
0161.
Fuck you. Donuts or sunsets?
Sunsets.
Arnie or Jim?
Arnie.
Katie or Frank?
Katie.
Organised fun or farting?
What?
What does that mean?
Organised fun.
Oh, a lovely one from Aunt Jo Simpson. Length or girth?
So, my sister's boyfriend made me realise that it could be a completely innocent question, and he probably means barbells or dumbbells.
I think he means willies.
I'm gonna go with barbells. Bourbons and barbells.
Tattoos or piercings?
Tattoos.
Museums or galleries?
Oh, I love the science museum.
3, 2.
Museums.
Beach or pool? That's a good one.
I don't love water.
Beach or pool? 3, 2, 1.
Beach.
River or lake?
Lake.
Fruit or veg?
Veg. Repping broccoli.
Cans or bottles?
Cans.
Would you rather, I've asked this one before, would you rather fight a horse-sized duck or a dozen duck-sized horses?
A dozen duck-sized horses.
That's it.
That's it.
Pizza or burgers?
Burgers.
Really?
Yeah.
That's disgusting. Bench press or deadlift?
Bench press.
Leg press or deadlift?
Leg press.
Leg press or bench press?
Leg press.
Leg press or squats?
Leg press.
Really?
I love you.
Lat pull down or leg press?
Leg press.
Morning or night?
Oh, I'm a morning person.
You are not a morning person.
Not here.
You're not a morning person.
Yes, I am.
Don't wake me up. I've said it 1,000 times, friend. Do not wake me up. Okay. One more. Pain au chocolat or Rollo yogurts?
Oh.
3, 2...
Pain au chocolat.
Or pain au chocolat dipped in... Okay, pain au chocolat or those sugar donuts dipped in Rolo yogurts?
Sugar donuts dipped in Rolo. Yeah.
Really?
It's a great combo. The little box of donuts that you can get in Tesco. Tiny ring sugar donuts and then dip it in a Rolo yogurt. And on that note, we're out.
I hope you've enjoyed this video. I was very nervous, so please leave comments down below on what you want to see and what you liked, maybe what you disliked, but say it in a nice way, please. And basically what you're going to see next is like a little trailer of what's to come, what I want to include in my channel, and what you should expect to see from me. I obviously am more on the side of mental health and fitness. So I hope you enjoy. And that's me.
Okay.
Instagram. The sun is getting
warmer. But when we soar away among the clouds. So hey guys, I hope you enjoyed my first video. Well, I've filmed a lot of things before.
I have.
I filmed a lot of things before and I've been too nervous to put them online. I don't really like to speak in front of a camera, so please bear with me.
So I probably will get
more.
I
will get more confident as time goes on. This guy is Frank Romano, he's Fitness with Frank on Instagram. Please go and follow him, he's a sick guy.
Okay, I can do it. I'm currently in the stages of
building the first website, so I do online coaching.
I'm clapping.
I do online coaching, and if there is anyone out there who would like to have me as a coach or anything,
no, I'm not. Is it?
Please don't.
That there's a bigger risk in being lazy, and there's a bigger risk in doing nothing, than there is in trying and failing and trying and failing. And I would rather be the person, and always have been, the person that tries and fails, and then picks themselves up, and tries again. And so far, so good, because I love my life. And it's going pretty well, so I'm going to try again. I've got it. Okay. Ooh, I'm so nervous.
She's currently in the stages of building a website. So if there's anyone interested in starting their fitness journey.
Oh, I didn't even think to promote my PT business.
Yeah.
Okay, can we have a breather and get me a gin? Okay, it's taken me 3 days to do this. Just because it's really nerve-wracking, and I find it even more nerve-wracking in front of Frank. And I don't really know why, because I sit there and happily do the videos in front of him. But I think it's a little bit of scared to self-promote. But I really hope you enjoyed this video. I really enjoyed making it. I really enjoyed editing it. I hope you got to know me a little bit better. And I hope the next videos will be a lot more gym focused, because we are back in from the 25th of July, which is very exciting for me. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and comment down below if there's anything else that you would like to see from me. I'm going to leave Frank's socials, my socials, his YouTube channel in the description box below as well. But yes, I hope you're having a wonderful quarantine, my baby angels. I love you. Thank you for watching. And yeah, this is my beautiful view right now. So, on that note, I am out. What if I fly? Hopefully I do.